Shri Vidya Samavedi. Welcome to the fifth and the final part of my blog of Antarctica. Hope you enjoyed the first four episodes. If you haven't watched it, the link is there in the description box. Antarctica is a very remote but unique continent. Millions of years ago, it was not like what it is today. It was a part of the supercontinent Gondwana, and it had lush green vegetation with dinosaurs roaming around. It was after the landmass that drifted away from the mainland that set the stage for Antarctica to cool down so dramatically. Today we are going to the Brown Bluff, which is an ice-capped volcanic cliff in the tip of the Antarctic Peninsula. Brown Bluff is formed by the eruption of a subglacial volcano leading to a table mountain framed by two glaciers. It has a narrow plain slope at the base of the Brown Cliffs. The flat top volcano is called Tuya. This is formed when lava erupts through thick glacier. The narrow beach is 3 kilometers long, filled with black pebbles. The beach has wind eroded brown boulders and blocks of ice from the glaciers. This is a home of 20,000 Adélie penguins and a small habitat of 700 pairs of gentoo penguins. Adélie penguins are the smallest and the most widespread penguins in Antarctica. It breeds in rocky, ice-free coastal areas. They are fantastic foragers, feasting mainly on krill. These fierce little creatures are known for stealing pebbles from their neighbor's nest. The penguins are standing in line to dive into the sea. The leopard seals are lurking on the coast. It's the breeding season, so we can see innumerable number of penguins protecting their eggs, incubating their eggs. Some penguins returning from the sea and searching for their mates. Few of them protecting their chicks, feeding them. It's a wonderful feeling observing these cute little flightless birds. And a chick. This one is jumping from the rock. We can see so many doting parents. Almost every other penguin has either an egg or a chick. They are all so busy bonding with their families. Happily. as they are gliding slowly over the calm waters. All set for the kayaking at the Brown Bluff.
So please stay all together, okay, with us, just here. So don't try to swell after, please, okay?
That's our kayak expert giving us instructions. Kayaking in Antarctica is a one-of-a-kind activity. It's a perfect way to explore the place and it allows us to get closer to nature. Penguins are going out to the sea in search of krill. Kayaking in these ice-cold waters amongst brash ice and porpoising penguins is a beautiful experience. These porpoising penguins are adorable. I was a little apprehensive about kayaking here because we were instructed to swim at least 50 meters to the zodiac in case our kayak overturns. I was worried about falling over during kayaking given the heavy wetsuit and the freezing sub-zero ice cold waters.
Yeah.
It's hot, huh? Really,
really warm, huh? Yeah, I can't imagine my plight if I fall down in this.
minus one.
Yes, I think it will be more than that.
0.5.
Penguins again. Coming towards us. Oh.
I feel a little jittery when my kayak hits the brash ice, making a crackling sound, but the kayak remains stable. There is nothing to worry.
It's iceberg. Iceberg.
It's real fun kayaking here in this brash ice.
What do you do?
That's a spectacular view of the Brown Bluff subglacial volcano. It's lunchtime for the penguins. That's why we see so many penguins porpoising here. Looks like they're all going in search of some tasty, delicious krill.
Oh my god, sorry. Yeah.
It happens. Yeah, everyone does it. It doesn't need any special skills to kayak in these calm waters. Antarctic Sound is a channel connecting the western coast of Antarctic Peninsula with the Weddell Sea. It is also known as the Iceberg Alley and some of the largest icebergs pass through it. It is a parking lot for giant icebergs and ice floes and is also known for its strong currents which make it dangerous for navigation. It is 50 kilometers long and 15 kilometers wide. Sometimes icebergs get grounded in shallow water and it is stuck for several years battered by winds and waves. Icebergs float in seawater and are of many colors. The greenish tinge is because of the presence of algae trapped in the ice. Black stripes are due to the soil impurities and could also be because of the volcanic ash. Blue color is because of the clear fresh water without any air bubbles. Only 1/10 of the iceberg is visible above the water, while 90% of the iceberg is underwater. Icebergs are tabular and non-tabular. Tabular iceberg has a flat top and steep sides. The largest icebergs are in tabular form. Very large ones are more than 213 meters long and 75 meters tall. The largest recorded iceberg broke off from the Ross Ice Shelf and measured 300 kilometers long. The non-tabular icebergs are block icebergs, which is like a large cuboid, dome, which is dome-shaped as the name states, wedge, which has a groove in the middle. Dry dock is an iceberg which is tall on one side and has been eroded on the other side, making it slope down. And then comes the pinnacle icebergs, which has pointed spires. Small pieces of ice are called growlers or bergy bits. Growlers are less than 5 meters in size, while bergy bits can vary anywhere between 5 and 15 meters. Icebergs can flip over as they melt. These are some of the most impressive visuals of the tabular icebergs in my trip to the Antarctic Sound. They are huge, gigantic, and I'm astounded by its massive size. It looks like a barrage. That's a violent send-off on our way back by Drake's Passage.
And that it is worth coming to Antarctica to experience that and to become ambassadors to go home and keep that notion of protection alive. So congratulations, everybody. You have experience in Antarctica. A big thank you to the staff as well. Thank you.
This brings us to the culmination of our tour of Antarctica, where nature is preserved in its pristine glory, untouched by humans. If you enjoyed watching my video, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. I'll see you again with a new episode. Till then, bye-bye.